Hi, let me show you how to use the npm plugin. So first, what we are going to do is to add some let's say the JavaScript plugin, just so we could have some data to work with. So let me quickly add the collection here, JavaScript dynamic. Okay, and let me grab some fake data here. Okay, and by the way, you can use Axios in here if you wish to also call yourself and manipulate data in there. It can be useful to test. Okay, so we've got some data, and now let's say we want to be able to manipulate this data, and I know a nice plugin for this, a nice package, sorry, and it's an npm package for this called lodash. So I can go here and go to extension, and in here we have access to the npm plugin. So we can click add in here, and you've got a search input where you can search for any package in here. So if you click the name, you can have access to the documentation, and of course if you can click on the GitHub icon, you can also check the documentation. So this is quite important, because depending on the plugin you add, sometimes you won't have the instance name. So we try to reference as many as we could, but if you struggle to find what name you need to type in here, just create a ticket and we will help you to find out in the repository what you should type in here to get access to the package. So when you're done in here, you can click save, and let me just add a table just here. Okay, let me select it. Let's do something like this, and let's select this container, and let's bind to our array of data. I can bind this text, this, and let's bind this to active. Okay, so let's say I wish to filter. So of course you can do it with this button, but let's use the package in here. So if you go now in formula, you will find the npm folder here and your package, and depending on the package you had, you will have access to many functions in here. So you can use them in the formula input, and of course in the JavaScript input. So in here, for example, I'd like to filter my array. So I've got filter here. Let's put the data inside. And if I remember well, I just have to do this. And I filtered my array with just the active users in here. Okay, so this is one way to use it. Let's play with another example. Let's add a variable. Okay. And this is a CSV string. Of course, let's do that. Okay, so in here I've got a variable formatted as a CSV, and I need it to be an object so I can manipulate this data. So I can go there again and add another package. So I think I know this one. Yeah, this one is nice. Okay, I can add it. Let's save. And now let's bind to something else. So I've got my CSV here, and of course if I do that, it won't work because it's not an array of objects. So normally I should be able to use this one. So I think it's parse, and let's parse this CSV. Okay, so the data, but it's an array of array. So let's go to to the documentation of this package, docs. And I think I need a config, yes, something like this, that's fine. I think it's this one. Let's try that. Let me go back to the project. So let's create another variable that I could call config in here. Side object, and let's add error true. Okay, so let me go back here, and in this action I can just add my config object, and it looks a lot better. So now if I do that, nice, it's bind, wonderful, I've got my data. So feel free to ping us if you don't know what to type in here. It's still in beta, and so we could iterate on this package to help you play with it. I hope you will like it.